ओके, क्वेश्चन 8। इफ एक्स क्यूब प्लस 3x अपॉन 3x स्क्वायर प्लस 1 इज इक्वल टू 341 अपॉन 91, देन प्रूव दैट x इज इक्वल टू 1। ओके, दिस क्वेश्चन इज मेड सिंपल बिकॉज दे हैव गिवन यूर द आंसर, अदरवाइज दे कैन आस्क यू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ x और सॉल्व फॉर x, इन दैट केस यू विल नॉट बी इवन नोइंग द आंसर। Okay, so we are going to solve this sum now. So the first step that I'm going to write is the question itself: x cube plus 3x upon 3x square plus 1 is equal to 341 upon 91. The first step that we are applying over here is componendo and dividendo. So this is going to become, first of both the numerators, then both the denominators, same thing on the right hand side. Okay, so I have written both the numerators first and then both the denominators because we are doing componendo and dividendo. Same thing I have done over here on the right hand side. So because it is componendo and dividendo, in the numerator it will be plus and that will be in the bracket. In the denominator it is going to be minus, that also will be in the bracket. Same thing over here on the right hand side, 341 plus 91, and this will be 341 minus 91. Okay, now these terms you can look at. Okay, what I'm having over here, I'm going to write that down once again after opening the bracket. So I have written these terms after opening these brackets, and 341 plus 91 is 432 and 341 minus 91 is 250. Of course, the first thing that is very simple that I'm going to do first, we can cancel this with 2. So this is going to become 216, 250 divided by 2, this is going to become 125. Okay, now 5 into 5 into 5 is 125, so this is basically 5 cube. 6 into 6 into 6 is 216, so this is 6 cube. It means here this part has to be the cube term. Okay, so this is 6 cube and this is 5 cube. So we are going to look over here for the cube term. Now the last digit over here is 1 plus 1. And here the last digit over here is minus 1. So this has to be some factor of cube. Either you should know what is factorization of cubic terms, or you should be able to divide it with either x plus 1 in the numerator or x minus 1 in the denominator. Okay, so basically this is going to be x plus 1 the whole cube. Okay, I've given you previously the expansion terms of a plus b the whole cube as well as a minus b the whole cube. This is a cube plus 3ab plus 3ab square plus b cube. You can also write this as a cube plus 3ab, a plus b and b cube. Okay. Same way over here, we can do the expansion of this, which is going to give us this term. Okay, so the expansion of a minus b the whole cube, that is a cube minus 3ab, a minus b minus b cube. So this term over here, if you are going to expand this, okay, you are going to get this has the factor x plus 1 the whole cube. The denominator is going to become x minus 1 the whole cube. So I'm just going to write that. We can work, you can work that and verify that parts x plus 1 the whole cube and x minus 1 the whole cube. I'm also going to show you how you are going to work that out, the expansion, if it is needed, x plus 1 the whole cube. This can be written as x plus 1 multiplied by x plus 1 the whole square. The cube part which is there, I have split this into two parts. The square term you already know. This is going to be a square plus 2ab plus b square. So this will be x square plus 2x plus 1. And of course here there is x plus 1 is there. Then you can open this bracket and you can get the final term. Same way you can do it for x minus 1 the whole cube. That is going to be x minus 1 multiplied by x minus 1 the whole square. So this part of verification, I'm giving it to you. We'll continue with the question. So this is left hand side is going to become x plus 1 the whole cube. Upon this is going to become x minus 1 the whole cube. This is equal to this. I already said this is 6 cube. And this is 5 into 5 into 5. That is 5 cube. Now both the sides, all the terms are in cube form. So I'm going to take cube root of both sides. So this is going to give me here, what is going to remain here is x plus 1 divided by x minus 1. This is equal to 6 upon 5. So I have taken the cube root of both the sides and written them. Now this is x plus 1, x minus 1. In numerator and denominator. So now I'm going to take componendo and dividendo. So again, I'm going to write the numerators first. So componendo and dividendo. So in the numerator, plus sign. In the denominator, minus sign. Okay, you can look for the like terms. X plus X. This is going to become 2X. These X. And minus x will get cut. Here plus 1, minus 1 will get cut. So what is remaining here in the numerator is 2x, x plus x. Okay, 1 minus of minus 1, this is going to become 2. This is equal to 6 plus 5 is 11. 6 minus 5 is 1. I can cut this 2 to 11 upon 1, of course, is 11. So x is equal to 11. Okay. I'm just repeating or reviewing quickly all the steps that I have done from the beginning. This is the question that is given to us. First, I'm doing componendo and dividendo. Okay. Then I get these terms. Cubic term is there. Okay, this after cancellation also I'm getting cube terms. So it has to do something with a plus b the whole cube and a minus b the whole cube. This I have partly shown you the working. The numerator term, that is this term, comes out to be x plus 1 the whole cube. And the denominator term works out to be x minus 1 the whole cube. All the terms are in cubes. So I'm taking cube root of both the sides. I'm getting x plus 1 upon x minus 1 is equal to this. Again, over here I'm applying componendo and dividendo. I'm getting the answer as x is equal to 11. You will take down this whole sum and I'm going to send you a few more sums of this type for practice.